Today, I'm inspired to illustrate cards and posters using nature. So you're going to need some art supplies, some pencils, and some paper, and you're going to need some nature. You could make your cards and your posters any way you want to. You could fold your paper in half, create your illustrations on the front of your card, on the inside of your card, color your illustrations in any way you would like to. You can make messages on the front. You can create messages on the inside of your card. You can send your card to a loved one who may live alone. Or maybe your card would be perfect for a family member, someone who does wonderful and awesome things for you throughout the year. You can make a poster that you can hang on your window or your door with a supportive message. Make your cards, your posters, any way you want because you are the artist.
Using two colors, I'm going to start by drawing a pink letter S. Then I'm going to trace above the pink line in blue. I'm going to trace below the pink line in blue. I'm going to connect my ends, and then I'm going to color in my letter. You can go very lightly with that pink line so that it doesn't show through. I'm going to continue coloring that in. I'm going to also try a letter M. I'm going to draw it in pink. I'm going to trace above the pink line in blue. I'm going to trace below the pink line in blue. I'm going to connect my ends. Maybe you don't want to color in your letter. You could try making it decorative. Add some polka dots, add some zigzags. That pink line can become part of the design. Have fun with your letters. When making a letter A, you want to leave some space in between the middle line. Then, as I'm tracing above with the blue and below the pink line with the blue, you can see it will fit right in. I'm going to connect my ends and connect my two middle lines. Again, you can color in the letter or you could decorate the letter. I colored my letters in rainbow order. I added a border around my word, and I even added some colorful spring pictures to my poster. Here's my window poster, ready to make someone smile.
Hi everybody, it's Mrs. Joseph, and I'd like to take a moment to wish all the mothers a happy Mother's Day. Today I'm going to show you how to make some cards that have a few extra surprises. I used a scrap piece of paper to make a stencil so that I could trace it and make multiple cards. I even made a small cutout so that I could have a surprise feature to my card. I folded in the middle and cut. It creates a flap that I can fold up and then draw something special inside. Don't worry if you don't have any drawing paper. You can always look for recycled paper. Maybe some old homework might be a good piece to use. This time I'm going to show you how to make a surprise that pops up. Cut two small slits, fold it up and back, turn to the inside, slide your finger in, and pop it in. Use some glue or tape to add your surprise. If you want to make something larger, make two sets of cuts, one on the left and one on the right.
Today we are marbling paper with shaving cream. Squeeze out a small amount and spread it evenly on your table. The shaving cream should be larger than the size of the paper you wish to marble. With watercolor, paint, or food coloring, add a few drops of color. Grab something to swirl your colors together, maybe a popsicle stick or a toothpick. Use a light touch and be careful not to overmix the colors together. Place your paper on top and lightly press the back. Peel your paper off of the shaving cream and place it on the table with the color side facing up. Use your tool to scrape the extra cream off of your paper. It can be placed back onto the pile and reused to make more marbled paper. This is a different way to add paint. This pile's already been used to make several pieces of paper, so I'm going to add a new color on top and marble that in. You can repeat the steps over and over again. You can marble paper, you can marble envelopes, whatever you've got. When it dries, you can draw right on top.
The materials for the nature printing you'll need will be some paintbrushes, paper towels, some water, and some paints like acrylic or tempera, some things found in nature like leaves, weeds, dandelions, flowers, maybe even something in your fridge, vegetables, fruits that you can cut up with an adult, and then you'll need your paper. I'm going to start with a leaf, one of my favorite things to print, especially in the fall. I always look for the back of the leaf to start. That's the part where the veins seem to stick out. So feel the leaf and paint with just a small amount of paint spread out on this back side. I find it best to hold it by the stem and paint away from you. Then you can pick it up by the stem, flip it over, use a paper towel to press it down onto your paper and make a beautiful print. Let's try some other materials I found. Thank you. you created some cards that you'd like to mail, write a message inside and place it in an envelope. Next, I'm going to write the address. I'm going to send it to Easton Hospital. If you'd like to send it there as well, the address is on the choice board. The first line is always the name of the person or place that will be receiving the letter. I'm going to write Easton Hospital, color out COVID. The second line is always the street number and the name of the street. The last line will be the city, which is Easton, Pennsylvania for the state, and the zip code. Next, in the upper left-hand corner, is where you put your name and address in case for any reason the letter needs to be returned to you. And then we need to place a stamp in the upper right-hand corner. And now your card, letter, or artwork is all ready to send in the mail.
Instead of paper, I used my iPad to create a card that I can send through email, text message, or any other digital platform. I created a digital card using Keynote and iMovie. First, I drew a floral wreath with a message in the center on Keynote on one slide. Then I used the feature Line Draw to play the drawing as a movie, which I uploaded to iMovie. On iMovie, I overlapped the movie with a song that I recorded to create the digital card.
Cause you matter to me, simple and plain, and not much to ask from somebody. You matter to me.